high school taking welding class. And he said, man, we just got to play with a plasma cutter, and it is so cool. But the instructor said something about a nibbler. What the heck is a nibbler? And could I compare the two of them? Well, that sounds like fun. Hang on. Here, wind it up. So this is a plasma torch, plasma cutter torch. It runs on electricity and compressed air. And when the air comes up through the gun, there's a little chamber inside here that makes the air swirl. And then inside this little tip, there's a nozzle. This is the nozzle. And there's a tip inside there. And you get an electrical arc going across that. And that's what creates the plasma. And then you get your flame coming out. Great for thicker metals. This one will cut up to a quarter inch. It's very fast, but it's kind of messy. Not like an oxygen acetylene torch messy, but you'll see. Look over here. So I just drew out a little pattern here. And plasma on one side and nibbler on the other. Watch this.
Corners.
You know, you can come in like here. They all have their purpose, I guess. You know, the plasma cutter, where it's for thicker metal, and the nibbler for thin metal. When I tried this on stainless steel, oh boy, that was bad. I broke these off just left and right. It was a little too heavy, a little too hard for the nibbler to run through. That's the difference.
Can you hold up your finished product there so we can see it?
Oh, God, it's not finished, but... here's where the plasma cutter cut. And you can see the heat distortion, or you can see the burning that's on there. And here's where the nibbler cut. No difference in the color of the steel at all. Now if you turn it over and you look at the backside, see this is all nice and smooth, and this is all kind of jaggedy, so I'd have to come back in and grind this off again, smooth this down to get rid of the slag. And I'd have to come in and just trace right along the edge of my line to get it right on the line. Where with a nibbler, you can get a lot closer and get in there. I guess it all depends on which piece of metal you're working with. And whether you have this toy or that toy. I mean, tool or that tool. Back to work. Bye.